this particular thing, okay, and then after that we are going to build this about section over here, okay, and this is the read more button over here, and then we are going to build this particular beautiful portfolio. And in this portfolio, once we hover on it, we are having a button over here. Then we are going to build call to action. Then we are going to build this particular beautiful theme team section over here, and let's build it. And we are also going to build our footer and other pages as well. So let's build it, okay. So this is our index.html file, and I'm going to create a class over here, okay. And this class I'm going to name it like services. So let's take it to here, okay, and services, okay, sorry, services. And this inside this class I'm going to give the h1 tag over here, and let's say I want to grab this particular title over here. So services we offer, okay, let's copy this particular thing and paste it over here. And then after that I want to grab this particular thing over here, and I want to paste it over here. And before pasting it, let me type paste it inside the p tag, okay. And then after that I want to give a br over here, so it will come normally, okay. Then what we are going to do now, we just completed it, and after that what I wanted to do, I want to take the row, and inside this row I'm going to build three columns, okay. So I'm going to give the name it like services call, and inside this services call we are going to build three we are going to build our you know, services, all of these services over here that are mentioned, okay. So let's say I want to copy this Bitcoin, okay, and I want to put a s3 tag over here, let's say Bitcoin, okay. And then after that I want to grab this particular thing and let's paste it inside the paragraph tag, okay. Then after pasting it, what I want to do I want to add a icon over here, and this is the icon, this is the Font Awesome icon that I already added. And in order to add your Font Awesome icon, you just need to grab your Font Awesome CDN over here. I already show it to you, and I'm not going to, you know, show it again. So just copy it over here, and I'm going to paste it just right here. And I'm gonna remove this name, and then I'm gonna give it a name like Bitcoin, BTC, and this is the Bitcoin icon over here. And then I can go over here and copy this whole column, okay. And I just copied it, and let's remove these two columns, and I want to replicate this column, okay. 1, 2, okay, I replicated it three times. First was the Bitcoin, then second is Ethereum, okay. And inside this Ethereum, what I need to type, FAB and then FA and then Ethereum, okay, Ethereum. Then after that what I need to do over here, I want to say like, as inside the S3 I want to say like dollar, and inside this like I want to say like FAS, then dollar, $SIGN, dollar sign. And let's see it like how does it look like after adding all of these things. So I'm opening it into the live server, okay. And then after that I need to do some changes in CSS, okay. So before doing anything, let's wait, and it is opening right now, so let's click it up once again, okay. So I have to wait. So this is opening right now, okay. And let's grab this particular URL over here, copy it, and I'm going to remove it, and I'm going to paste it over here. So let's paste this URL that I just copied, okay. And here you can see we just got our services, we just got our Bitcoin along with the icon, Font Awesome icon, we got just our dollar, Okay, so I want to take it to the center. So let's target the services, okay, and target the h1 and p tag as well. So I'm going to comment it out like services section, okay, and inside this services section we are going to target our class. Okay, so inside this class what I want to give, I want to give the width around 80%, okay, and that's enough. 80% width margin must be auto, and then after that I want to give, I want to say like text align must be center, and I want to say like I want to give the margin top from the top, okay, 100 pixel around. So top to bottom, top from the margin top, it got 100%. Okay, so this is how it looks like after adding this particular class. Okay, then we have h1 inside that particular thing. So let's say h1 must be 2.5 rem, not 1 point, it's 2.5 rem. Okay, then after that I want to give the font width of this particular thing, and font weight I'm going to give around 600. Okay, then after that I want to type p tag over here. Okay, and inside p tag there's a color that I'm going to use, that is 777. Okay, and inside this color I want to give the font size around 0.8 rem. Okay, and then after that what I want to do, I want to give the line height. Line height must be around 300. Okay, and let's see what will happen after adding all of these things. And here you can see, let's reload this. Okay, what I just did. So where is our content? Okay, let's see. I don't know why this is not showing. Okay, let's come save it, and let's say I want to save it. I already saved it. I don't know why this is not reflecting. Let's open it once again. Okay, open it once again inside the live server, and I want to say like, okay, so let's grab it and paste it over here once again. I think something is wrong. Let's paste it over here. Something is wrong with my particular browser. And why it is not showing me anything? What I did wrong over here? Let me check. I'm going to pause this video. Okay, the reason that it was not showing is because I was given line height around 3000 and I was not focusing on it. So basically I don't need to give the line height 3000. I want to give the font width at least 300. Okay, and I don't know how does happen. So let's give the padding around 10 pixel. Okay, and let's reload it. Okay, reload this particular thing, and this is our heading we are just getting over here. Okay, and I want to say something of like, I want to give the br not just here. Okay, and to paste my br somewhere else. So let's paste it over here. Okay, and that's enough. So yeah, that's cool. So after adding our br tag over here, what do we need to do? So here you can see that we just got this particular paragraph over here. Okay, and then after that just go over here, and here you can see we just got our row over here. Okay, just copy this particular class over here, paste it. Okay, and then what you need to do, I just wanted to give the margin from the top. Okay, and from the top I want to give the margin around 5%, and let's see. After giving the margin, okay, we just got the margin over here. Okay, and then after that I want to give the display flex, and after giving the display flex you can see, okay, you can see these are coming you know, side by side, and this is how you can achieve just by giving, you know, display flex and by targeting your row. Okay, and then I just want to give the name like justify content space between. I just wanted to space in both of the all of these things. Okay, so we just completed it. Then what we need to do, we need to target our columns. Okay, so let's copy it and paste it over here. Okay, and inside this column I want to give the some flex basis over here, and inside this flex basis I want to give around 31% is enough. Okay, and then I want to give the some background over here, and inside this background what I want to paste like F8 F9 FA. okay, so this is the background we just got. This is a light background, light white background you can say. And then I would just wanted to give the border radius around. I want to give it like some border radius so it can come like this. Okay, some border radius from here. Okay, and then after that what I wanted to give, I just wanted to give the margin from the bottom. Okay, so I just wanted to give the margin from the bottom 5% as well. That is also enough. And after giving the margin, and we just cut it over here. And then after that I'm going to give the padding. Okay, and inside this padding I want to give the top to bottom 20 pixel and 12 pixel left to right. Okay, and that's it. And let's say, okay, we just got our margin padding over here. Then let's say I want to give the hover effect into the services column. Okay, and in order to give the hover effect you just need to type colon hover. Okay, and let's give the some box shadow. Okay, so it will come like that. So let's give the box shadow around 20 pixel. Okay, and then like red, green, blue, alpha, and I want to give the value of alpha around 0.3, and that's enough. And then after that you'll see that there is a border once we hover on it. Okay, and what I need to do, I need to give the cursor pointer. Okay, cursor must be pointer, and transition, I want to give the some transition over here. So transition is going to be around 0.5 second. okay, 0.5 second transition. And here you can see we just got very beautiful transition once we hover on it. And this is how you can, you know, you can target these things. Okay, so yeah, this is how you can easily do some changes. And let's come over here, and what we need to do now, we need to target our FAB, which is a font awesome icon. Okay, so in order to target it, like target the services column, then target this particular class FAB. okay, and then I need to target another part class, that is FAS. You can see it over here. Okay, this is FAS, the third one is, okay, FAS. And then I wanted to give the some font size. Okay, font size must be around 50 pixel. I want to give the font size around 50 pixel. Okay, and I want to change the color, so I'm going to give the color around like this. Okay, then you can see that we just got very beautiful you know, services section over here. Okay, and this is how you can easily create your services section. And then I just wanted to give the service column, and here we can see that this is the Ethereum, dollar and Bitcoin. We just given it like inside the H3. okay, so we need to target this S3 as well. So I'm going to target this S3. okay, and then I want to give the font size, so font size must be around 20 pixel. okay, and let's see like how it looks like after giving the, okay, that's cool. So 20 pixel is enough for the font size. And we just completed this particular services section over here, and you can see this is looking very beautiful. Okay, then after that we are going to create a about section. Okay, so in order to create about section, let me show you how does our about section looks like. So let's say I want to open this project, open it from here, and this is our about section. And I'm gonna give you this particular code for free. Okay, so you can easily access these codes for free just by visiting on my GitHub. Okay, and this is learn about blockchain on all of this stuff, and there's a button over here. So let's achieve this particular thing. Okay, So let's come up over here, and I'm going to create another section that is called about section. Okay, let's format this format document. Click on format document, and this is looking perfect right now. Okay, and let's do some other changes. Okay, about section, let's call it about section. Okay, and I want to call it about section. Let's say inside this about section we are going to write our, okay, so I want to give the like about block block chain. Okay, I want to give the name like about blockchain. Okay, I want to give the this name of this class. Okay, then I wanted to give the row. Okay, row class, and inside this row I want to take two columns, because in the first column I want to, here you can see, I want to take two columns. In the first column I want this particular text over here, and then in the second column I want to this particular image over here. Okay, then after this this text, we just need to add a button over here. Okay, so how you can achieve this, let me show you. So let's say I want to add h1 over here. Okay, and let's grab this particular font, because I don't want to I don't want to type it, because I don't want to waste your time. And after that, what we need to do, we need to type a paragraph over here, and inside this paragraph we just got very beautiful this particular title over here. Let's say I want to give some space over here, and that's enough. Give some space over here. Okay, then after that, what I need to do, I want to add another paragraph inside this. Okay, so let's add another paragraph, and let's copy this particular thing as well. Okay, so this is the another paragraph, and we successfully copied it. Okay, so let's say I want to give some space over here, so you can easily see it, like how does it looks like. And before doing anything, let's format the document. Okay, so that's it. After adding this, you can see we just got okay, so before doing anything, before adding our paragraph, before adding our heading, I already told you that we need two columns over here. Okay, so I'm going to give the class over here, so about call. Okay, so inside this call we are going to paste all of these things that we already copied. Okay, so let's, you can grab it over here like this. Okay, let's copy this. Okay, and let's paste it inside it. So this is coming inside it. Okay, then after that I want this particular section just next to it, because I wanted to add two column. Okay, and after this column I wanted to close a div. Okay, and inside this div, what I need to do, I want a image over here. Okay, so let's grab a image. So let's come up over here, and let's say okay, so inside, how we can grab the image? So here we are having this particular YouTube project. I'm having this particular YouTube project over here, and let's say I want to, okay, so YouTube project is over here. Okay, and there's a new project that I already created. So I'm going to grab all of the image from here. So yeah, these are all the image that I need to copy before doing anything. So I think this is the project that we are having. Okay, yeah, this is the project that we are having right now. So I just completely copied it. Okay, and let's skip this file over. Okay, so let's add our image just by typing like img. okay, and inside this img I am having a 1,4.jpg over here. Okay, I'm gonna change this name, and I'm gonna give all of the image for free as well, like you can easily get all of these images. So let's see how our website looks like after adding this image. Okay, so here you can see this is looking very ugly, very bad, and we need to change some of the things over here. Okay, so let's come up over here, and target this particular thing, like we need to target this particular about blockchain class. Okay, and then what we need to do, let's come up over here and let's say this is our about section start, and then I want to make some changes in it. Okay, so in order to take it to the middle, let's add a width around 80%, margin must be auto, and then I want to add a text align that I already added, center, text align must be center. Okay, then after that what we need to do, margin top must be around 100 pixel, and that's it. Here you can see we just got margin and text align 80% width and height. Okay, and that's it. After that we just need to target this column, okay, about column, and this will going to fix most of the things. Okay, so let's grab this about column, and flex basis must be around 48%, and that's enough. And I want to give this some padding, so I want to give top to bottom from around 30 pixel and left to right around let's say 5 pixel. Okay, not xp, it's pixel. Okay, and let's say reload this particular thing, and here we are getting nothing right now, but yeah, we got two columns with a flex basis 48% around. Okay, and then let's target our image, and that's it. This is the one of the biggest thing that we need to target right now. So let's say I want to target it, and I want to give it name around, I want to give the width around 100%. Okay, so let's say just save it, and let's say I want to reload this. Okay, and after reloading this is not coming like that. I don't know what is wrong with it. About column is okay, and we just, okay, I just want to target the image as well, not just only column. Okay, so here you can see we just completely got this particular section just by adding image 100% width. Okay, and we just got this particular section over here. And what else we need to do, we need to add a button just in it. Okay, so in order to add your button, what you need to do, let's come up over here and do some changes. Okay, so after this particular p tag, what you need to do, I'm going to use anchor tag, you can also use btn and button. Okay, you can also use you can also use button as well, but I'm going to use anchor tag. Okay, so inside this anchor tag, let's give the class btn, which I already created. Okay, and inside this button I wanted to say read. Okay, read and more, read more. Okay, and that's it. After adding this, you're gonna see there's a button coming over here. Okay, and I think I added the wrong button over here. I think our button class is hero btn, it must be hero btn, I think. So yeah, I think it's hero btn. Okay, yeah, we just added our hero btn button over here. Okay, and after that hero btn, I wanted to add extended btn. Okay, I want to add a class over here. Okay, and inside this extended btn, after targeting this extended btn, I wanted to make some changes inside this button. Okay, so this button must be look different after adding some of the CSS properties over here. So before doing anything, let's add one pixel border solid. I want to change the color of the border, so I want to give the black color around. So let's do it. And then I want to give the font size around, I want to give the font size around 13 pixel, and that's enough. And after that, I want to give the margin from top to bottom, left to right, around 10 pixel, top to bottom, left to right must be 30 pixel. Okay, let's say 30 pixel is must and enough. So let's see how it looks like. Okay, this is looking perfect. And then after that, what I need to do, I need to give the color. okay, and inside this color I want to give the same color, that is black. Okay, and after that what I need to do, I wanted to give the hover effect on the extended BTM, so let's add the hover effect on it. So after adding the hover effect, what you need to do, I want to only change the color over here. Okay, inside, in order to change your color, what you need to do, I want to give the white color over here. Okay, and after giving the white color, you can see once we hover on it, okay, this is turning, this particular thing is turning, you know, turning white, and this is totally fine. Okay, then what do we need to do, we just need to add a background transparent, okay, before doing anything. So this is still transparent, but let me make sure that we can add transparent background. Okay, so this is how our button looks like, and here you can see. Okay, and yeah, our button is looking cool. Okay, and then what we can do in order to, you know, in order to do other thing. So yeah, we just completely added this. And if you want to do make some changes, like if you want to make changes in your like about column paragraph tag, if you want to change the font size, you can also do that. Font size must be like, if you want to give the font size around 20 pixels, you can easily do that. You can see like font size has been increased, but I'm not going to do that because this is looking so ugly and so weird. So yeah, 15 pixel, yeah, that would be great. Yeah, 15 pixel is looking good. And you can also increase the, you know, I'm going to increase the, like let's say I want to duplicate it. Okay, and then I can also increase this particular thing as well. Let's duplicate it. Okay, after duplicating it, here you can see we just got it over here, up like this is okay. And I just wanted to remove this, you know, about call fee. You can you know, you can change some of the things, but yeah, that's enough. Okay, so yeah, we are getting a very beautiful, you know, about section as well. And after that, after about section, what we need to create, so basically after that we are going to look at it, how we can create our portfolio section. So let's wrap it over here, and in the next tutorial I am going to create our portfolio section, and I'll gonna show you how you can easily create this particular thing just by using HTML, CSS and JavaScript, not JavaScript, HTML and CSS and Flexbox inside the HTML, CSS. Okay, bye bye, take care, thanks for watching.